following announcement has been paid for by the WZWA Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to WZWA Network presents WWE Raw. I am Juicy Boy alongside Hunter Hurst Hogsley. Coming up tonight, we've got the legendary Eddie Guerrero taking on Dolph Ziggler.
And you are here with your boy Hogsley. Where's the energy, Juice? You need to give it to me because this is so exciting. Coming up, we've got AJ Styles versus Bryan Danielson in what will be a hell of a match.
I'm sure it's going to be, the indie fans are going to cream their jocks, but I don't know if they're going to cream their jocks over Seth Rollins versus Sheamus. Should be a banger, as he likes to call it, in the main event.
Oh, then we've also got a classic here, Jerry the King Lawler versus R-Truth. I'm personally excited for this one. I can't even think about how that's going to play out.
Well, it's good, you know, it's a good thing that you're excited about it, bro, because it's coming up next. It's actually opening the show. The legendary Jerry the King Lawler.
From the top of the mountain, the peak of wrestling to opening Raw. It's been a long fall, hasn't it, Jerry? But it's good to see you, buddy.
Well, I mean, to be honest, he's like in the opening match of like the biggest wrestling company in the world on like an internationally televised TV show, making hundreds of thousands of dollars a year. So it's not really, it's like, if anything, his career's only thrived as his wrestling career has wound down. His overall earning power seems to have just gone up.
Well, no doubt he makes more money. Well, I mean, wrestlers made what? A fucking pittance back in the day. They were paid in steak sandwiches.
Well, I mean, not if you are someone in Jerry Lawler's position, but oh my God, dude, here he comes.
You feel me? Stand up. Oh man, look, what's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? I'll tell you what's up, R-Truth, and that is my penis. It is good to see you as well.
Yeah, I'm not even fucking dignifying that shit. I'm not even dignifying that shit.
There's no shame among the homies, mate.
No, there is.
It's a natural bodily function. Just a bit of blood in your penis area causing it to go erect.
No one's saying that there's issues between the homies or whatever. It's just there's a problem when you do it. Like, it's an issue when you start doing it.
Look, it may be tiny, but it's nothing to be ashamed of. Anyway, let's stop
your fucking
penises.
I'm talking about your rapping ability. Okay, the opening contest is underway. The legendary... Oh my.
Oh. I mean, Jerry might just be out of his depth here.
Well, I'm not sure.
He's got the age.
I mean, of course, R-Truth is a former NWA World Heavyweight Champion. Jerry Lawler is the legend, the King of Memphis. Oh, there's one of Jerry Lawler's favorite bumps there. He loved going off that apron for a big match. Big time bump, but in any case, you know, he is limited in his older age, and he's gonna have to use. Drops him with that atomic drop.
He's gonna use every trick he's got in his book, and that is a big book of tricks. Someone with that level of experience.
I mean, you know, he's probably forgotten more about wrestling than the average WWE superstar even knows.
Especially with the Alzheimer's starting to set in at that old age.
Well, Hugsley, okay. In any case, R-Truth mounting an offense here.
I can't say homoerotic stuff, but you can say that he's mounting someone.
Oh, and he's mounting R-Truth. Yeah, precisely. And he mounts R-Truth. Oh, just stomps him on the back of the head. That's that wily veteran. His back was facing the referee when he did that. Oh, and again, that's a closed fist. But his back was obscuring that closed fist from the referee. Oh,
he's working up the crowd here, Juice.
Oh, and he knocks him.
You know, it just wants to mount him again. That athletic body of R-Truth.
Referee Irwin L. Long.
Very clever, very clever.
Officiating, nice cross body block there. These two
misses the grapple.
Like, make no mistake about it, he may carry himself like a king, but Jerry Lawler is no stranger. Oh, as I was just
saying. Oh, that was very dangerous for R-Truth. He almost clipped his fucking head off those steel steps.
Oh, no, and yeah, and the environmental awareness perhaps isn't all that it should be with a guy like R-Truth, but I mean, I was going to say, Jerry Lawler's no stranger to fighting on the outside. You know.
Well, I mean, back in his days, his rings didn't have any padding. No. It was just straight up concrete. That's what it was made.
In essence, there was no difference to taking a bump inside the ropes than there was taking it outside the ropes. and just a kick to the skull of
Austin. And now you've got these soft bastards here having to have padding on the outside. Put some hair on your balls and take a bump like a real man or a woman. Women can take good bumps as well.
Oh, well, we got to have our ringside padding. We got to have our ringside, like our floor, our ring mat foam. Like
weak.
Yeah, it's pathetic. But in any case, Jerry Lawler has now used his veteran instincts, Hogsley, to take control of this match. Oh, I was going to say, but R-Truth.
Wow.
Just kicked the living shit out of the legendary Jerry the Kid. Jerry didn't even dignify that, bro.
Jerry might have the experience he juiced, but R-Truth's got the athleticism. He's got the cardio. Yeah, he's got the strength. He's a young bull.
Yeah,
okay?
He's hungry. Wait a second. Pile driver.
Oh, no. The signature pile driver from Jerry Lawler. That might be it.
Referee taking time.
R-Truth looks at R-Truth.
Oh, my.
That was thrilling. Thrilling stuff there, thrilling. Juice.
Scintillating near fall. Jerry Lawler now. R-Truth.
It's left me exsanguinated.
Yeah, absolutely. My penis is going to exsanguinate in a minute. And it's only the opening contest, bro. Here. Oh,
very clever. They're working the leg of R-Truth.
That's
you
right.
Can't mount any offense of bum leg.
Yeah.
You need that foundation. Everything is built up from the foundation.
Lawler now. Lawler's going to go for that.
When is he going to do that? Oh, Jesus.
Lawler absolutely just all of his weight came crashing down. That's going to be, oh no.
Whoa. Mounted him there for the pinfall, but only gets the two count.
Yeah, really, you know, laid in there like a deep mount. And
a deep mount.
Deeply. Oh, and a dropkick.
Oh, R-Truth with the awareness. I want a follow-up dropkick. That's how you do it, the king.
Really,
that's how the dropkick is done.
Now he's starting to mount some offense of his own.
Mounting that left leg.
Slash Cobra twist. Jerry the King Lawler now. Oh, wait a second. Oh, and Lawler with some unexpected
athleticism. The wiry veteran.
Oh, and here we go. The classic headlock and John Tolles punch. Follows it up with the axe handle, and now he just stalks R-Truth. And here's the important thing to remember, Hogsley. If he can damage one of R-Truth's legs severely enough, and, you know, he can neutralize that scissors kick, that spinning axe kick. He's gone for it again, bro.
No. That has to be it. If you're R-Truth. Not out, if your soul hasn't left your body, you're not human.
One, two, that's it. Three.
The experience paying off. The king, he's back, and he opens Raw with an absolute domination of R-Truth.
And here we see, R-Truth managed to continually keep the king on his toes this entire time, Hogsley. But
we're talking about a man here who's got to be at least 87 years old.
Well, no, he's
still almost, talented, still got the stuff.
He's almost, he's about 70, but... So, and then you see this incredible feat of athleticism for a man of Lawler's years, but hits him with that headlock into the John Tolles punch, takes him down. That was where he would hit that second pile driver, and R-Truth... Valiant effort, though he may have put down, it just wasn't enough. Irving L. Long coming in for the count. Wait a second, Bad Bunny! It's Bad Bunny! What the heck is he doing here?
He's old enough to be your great grandfather!
Oh, what? I don't know what the fuck that was all about, but
come on. Okay, Sensei Gus.
We've got Sonya Deville taking on Dakota Kai. We've got
Someone needs to tell Dakota Kai that 2002 wants its hairstyle back.
Yeah, it does. It definitely does. Here comes Sonya Deville, former general manager of the women's division, and multiple other, random on-screen roles that they gave her.
I thought that was Stephanie.
She kind of started doing all of those Stephanie-type things once Stephanie went off TV again. But anyway, she's back in the ring now in match number 2 of Raw.
God, she's looking fit. She's looking tight.
Yeah, she's fit as fuck, bro. And here comes her opponent, Dakota Kai.
You think with a hairstyle like that, she'd be walking out to some Avril Lavigne.
Yeah.
It's just grotty. It's gross. I'm a man with luscious locks, so I know what it's like to have good hair. And that's not given to me right now, Juice.
No, you don't.
Look, there's no Tresemme in there. There's no Garnier Fructus in it.
What would you know? Let's just... and Dakota Kai going for...
Just ruined.
Ruined. Just a smack across the face. That's what you get. The referee gets in between them and says, no. I'm going to ring the bell. I'm going to ring the bell before this is going to start. Just turn them loose, ref.
They can beat the shit out of each other.
Oh. And it's on. Mounting her, and it's on like Juicy Kong, which you can check out. And now she reverses it, reverses into her mount of her own.
Have to think, with that greasy hair leaking onto her back, it's just hard to get a hold of her.
Do you have to be gross? just takes her down.
Yes, I do, Juice. I just call it as I see it. Okay. Just working the back.
Oh, and that
just
time.
Winging it, just cracking those ribs.
Oh, waistlock takedown. Oh, rear mount, and then turns it around. Snapmare.
Oh, snapmare. Beautiful snapmare by Dakota.
That
has to be dangerous.
Double stomp and penalty kick. And, drops a knee onto that elbow joint. Try to disable those deadly submissions of Sonya Deville.
Working the limbs always is the smartest decision. You've got to be smart in the ring, and that's what we're seeing right now from Sonya Deville.
We're seeing an exchange, though, at this moment of just an exchange of raw power between these two. Just raw power.
God, it's a war at the moment, Juice. Just back and forth with his heavy strikes. These are bombs that are being landed. This is some Brandon Moreno versus Alexandre Pantoja level shit right here.
Flattens her out with that diving reverse DDT. It's Hagler versus Hearns here. Mid kick and another one. Boom.
That's
clothesline.
Devastating. That might be it here for Dakota Kai.
Mounts her, covers her. Dakota Kai kicks out at 2 3/4.
But. Shit. Is that going to be a mistake for Dakota Kai?
I think that.
Is she just prolonging the inevitable, just copying more abuse?
That could be it. No. I thought.
Sonya, she's angry.
Wow.
They're swapping mounts.
There's some serious beef between these two. Like Dakota Kai came out here, I think, in good faith, bro. Extended the hand for a handshake. Oh. Sonya Deville pretended that she was going to reciprocate, did not, smacked her in the face. Oh, nice neck breaker by Sonya Deville.
I think Dakota Kai is just jealous of the better wrestler that is Sonya Deville, the better looking woman, the just more respectable member of the Raw brand.
And you see Dakota Kai landed hard on the outside mat, and we were joking around before and making some comments about the protective mounts, but really
Juice, that is devastating. I get what you're saying. We are making fun of it, but that is still maybe an inch of padding. That is not enough when you were getting thrown down there.
Yeah, absolutely not. It's it's less than what you might find in some jiu-jitsu gyms. So But honestly, Dakota Kai has her stomach went right into the corner of those steel steps.
That's got to injure her right in her ovaries, man.
Yeah. Sharp elbow. Wait a sec. This is just an absolute all-out brawl. Like, it's a slugfest.
Now, these are heavy closed fist punches as well that these women are landing.
Off the ropes, drop down, leapfrog.
Oh, Universal's
running in the way. Oh, and they malfunction.
What are you doing, ref? Get in the corner. Know the spot. Know your role. Just ruins what would be a great momentum just burst for Sonya Deville. It just does my head in.
Yeah, the referee is pretty much a dick.
Oh, just mounting her. Oh, transitions into a triangle hold of some sort.
And is he... Wait a second. No. It's almost like an inverted Rings of Saturn there, Hogsley. Into the corner. Oh, and the elbows have been...
No, just... It keeps going on. I've seen less action in UFC fights.
Not a great camera angle there, but that was a great boot to the face there. That was going to be all there.
I thought it was. After all the offense Sonya has landed, Dakota Kai just refuses to go away.
A second one.
Oh, the go to sleep.
That's going to be all. Dakota Kai is going to get this. Two.
No way. Sonya refuses to go away as well. This is a war.
I was gearing up to say Dakota Kai had gotten the upset win there, Hogsley. But Sonya Deville showed why she is one of the fiercest competitors.
But when you've got that nasty ass hair in your face, you'll do anything to get up and out of it.
Yeah, okay. So, after
crossbody.
Yeah. Very nice crossbody, and now ripcord, running calf kick, returned with a clothesline by Sonya Deville. The action is so fast and furious. Mid kick, punch, and another punch.
Oh, just heavy bombs. These are heavy bombs, but that's a heavy elbow.
Wait a sec.
This won't stop, and I don't want it to stop. Oh, this should just be the rest of Raw because I cannot get enough of it, Juice.
That's the third one. It's going to be it right here, too. She's done. Dakota Kai.
She couldn't hold on.
I think it needs to be pointed out as we see a replay of some of the action here in this great, great match that Dakota Kai had to hit that finishing move of hers, that GTS finishing move of hers. She had to hit that three times before she was able to put
You can see from these highlights that she was working these orbital to bone. She was busting up that nose with heavy elbows, heavy punches, heavy knees, and then three GTSs. No one's coming back from that.
Yeah, and you could see very smartly there Dakota Kai put herself in between Sonya Deville and the ropes, eliminating any chance of Sonya Deville getting to those ropes. But hard-fought victory in this great match, and I have to assume that it's not done between these two, because they don't seem to be getting along at all, and Sonya Deville's not going to be happy about that match. But Dakota Kai,
after being disrespected like she was at the beginning of the fight, she isn't going to let this down. Live it down.
Coming up next, we have a match in the World Heavyweight Championship tournament match. It is Eddie Guerrero taking on Dolph Ziggler.
God, what a dream matchup this would be.
Absolutely, and here he comes.
Latino Heat! He lies, he cheats, and he stole our hearts. We miss you, Eddie.
Yes, we miss you, Vato. Miss you, Vato. Like, why am I getting emotional? So anyway, Eddie Guerrero coming out here on Raw for this World Heavyweight Championship tournament match. He's in
tremendous shape. And why are you getting emotional? Because he defined our childhood.
Yeah.
Right. We grew up idolizing him. Who doesn't love Eddie Guerrero? It makes me emotional. But you know what? I've also got a soft spot for this guy right here, and that is Dolph Ziggler. Love a man with good, luscious locks like that. That is clearly the Tresemme. That's the Garnier Fructus hairstyle that we all need to see. Yeah. You can imagine there's a bit of beef between them because Dolph Ziggler obviously stealing Eddie's wife away just after she passes. No man's going to be okay with that, even in the afterlife.
Well, actually, Vicky didn't pass. She's still alive.
No, Eddie passed, you idiot.
Yeah, but you said she passes. Dude, you're correct. There is beef. You're exactly right, man. It stems from, you know, Eddie was like, you think while I was away, while I was up there, I wasn't watching
what you were doing? You could fuck Vicky?
You thought you could just fuck my wife while I was gone? I'm going to fuck you up. So Eddie Guerrero, you know, there's heat, and the referee is already down. Erwin L. Long is down on the mat.
Well, he's pulled triple duty so far. Give the guy a break.
Well, he is having a break right now. That's why the spot is called.
Just great show of athleticism from Eddie. He's not lost a step. He hasn't missed a beat.
He absolutely, well.
I mean, he's missing a few heartbeats, but that's a different story.
Okay. Gory Special, the move invented and popularized by his father, Gory Guerrero. Reversed into a nice arm drag by the former collegiate wrestler.
To the gut/testicles.
And Ziggler now trying to work over that arm of Guerrero, trying to get advantage in this match, in this human chess match. Blocks that basement dropkick attempt from Eddie. He's been studying the tape of Eddie Guerrero. Guerrero, of course, has not wrestled a match since 2005. So this is his first foray into the modern world of professional wrestling.
How much it has changed since Eddie wrestled. He's got a lot to adjust here. Adjust to, Juice.
That's right. He has a lot to adjust to. It's been 18 years since he's been in the ring.
He needs to realize you don't sell moves anymore. You just get straight back up.
Yeah, he doesn't. Yeah, he's probably confused right now why Dolph Ziggler's been beating the shit out of him. and Guerrero now starting to get rough. Oh, and the strikes are starting to be thrown between these two. We knew it wouldn't be long before it devolved into a fight.
Wow, we knew there was bad blood between them.
Yeah, we knew that it was going to be a good match regardless of whether it was a fight or a technical match because these two are so good. But Guerrero now looking to get fancy. Oh,
he's angry. He's heating up. Vacuum. He's Latino heating up.
Heat. Oh, man.
Oh, with a great counter there, Juice.
Excellent.
Eddie doesn't know where he is right now.
Absolutely beautiful counter. Another example of that tape watching. And Guerrero now.
Oh, he's in a bad spot here, Juice. He's in a bad spot.
This is not good, dude.
Ooh. Oh, to the back of the head! That ends people's careers, that ends people's lives, that is dangerous!
And Guerrero now, perhaps getting a little discombobulated by the extra LED lights that surround him that weren't a part of television wrestling.
He's also wondering what this soft surface is under him right now. That must be confusing him. He must think he's still in the ring from how soft it is out there.
Why can't he, you know, feel Kurt Angle's breath on him calling spots? But in any case...
neckbreaker.
Elevated neckbreaker, but Ziggler no-sells it, just like we were talking about.
Yeah, exactly. Eddie doesn't know what to do. He doesn't know what to do when someone doesn't sell moves.
And he hits that annoyingly named zigzag and follows it up with a basement dropkick. The zigzag, by the way, is simply a jumping reverse DDT. Now he's going to rip off Shawn Michaels.
Eddie should see this coming, though. Eddie's familiar with this.
No, he...
Eddie knew it was coming. That's why you don't tune up the band. You don't let everyone know. You break it out.
Shit, bro.
That's what I'm talking about, though. You can't let him know where it's coming from.
Oh, wait a sec. He's managed to get himself to cover anyway.
The legend just couldn't put it all together there, Juice.
Look at this. We're seeing... I actually think Guerrero got kind of robbed there, to be honest. And we're seeing some nice... It was a good...
We're robbed? What do you want about Juice? He didn't do anything.
Honestly,
it was a punchy bag all night.
Look at this.
Yeah, but okay. It gets reversed after this. Man, there was no five-star frog splash. There was no three amigos.
Hang on. Just hang on.
I'm hanging on!
Look at this. It gets countered, right? Boom. Fair enough. That's all good. Boom. Beautifully counters the fucking super kick. You know, excellent. And then what?
It just wasn't enough juice!
No sell. Boom. And then look at that crap, disrespecting him by dropping down as if he's knocked out.
Well, when you're gonna fuck a man's wife, what are you gonna do? Shake his hand? Give him respect? No! You're gonna fuck him too!
Now he's like ripping off. He's mocking Guerrero's patented slap of his chest. The mark of respect that he would give to his fans. Oh, you're ripping it. Oh, you dirty bastard.
Yeah. Coming up. All right, coming up. Oh, we've got the Young Bucks versus Rico. And I know as a big fan of AEW and a big fan of the Young Bucks, I'm very excited for this one, Juice.
No, I'm not. I'm actually not excited at all. But here we go.
I know Rico Strowman's disappointing for you, but I know the Young Bucks are going to do enough to like get you involved, mate.
They're both disappointed, but you know.
And here they are. Here they are. Best tag team. You know, the greatest tag team, even better than the Road Warriors, better than the Dudley Boys. Here they are, Juice, the Young Bucks.
Excuse me, I just threw up in my mouth a little bit. So here comes Nick and Matt Jackson, the Young Bucks, the Young Fox, the Young Bucks, and also once known as Generation Me in TNA. And here they are looking really annoying. And
now they're known as the GOATs, okay? Give them the credit they deserve, that they have earned, okay?
No, they've...
Animal Hawk, Devon and Bubba, they've got nothing on Nick and... Who did you say the other guy was?
Matt.
Nick and Matt, okay?
Yeah, in any
Those
case...
Those are names you remember.
Okay, fuckface. In any case, Ricochet of... Rico Man, or whatever the fucking name is, of the tag team. One half of the tag team. Here he comes. And he's going to jog down to the ring like he's a soccer mom. Oh, that was impressive, though. Very nice. And here comes his tag team partner. He's not controlling his own narrative. We're controlling it. The network controls it. You understand? Your computer.
So is Rico Strowman a real tag team?
Yeah, it is, but it's not actually named that. That name.
Because it should be Team Beard, because those are both luscious, luscious beards, okay? That's the kind of facial hair you just want to run your fingers through, Juice.
I don't particularly want to do that, I have to say. Okay.
Yes, you do, because look, it tickles you.
All right, so it's Matt Jackson. You've got me discombobulated, Hogsley. So it's
because you're thinking about those luscious beards, but here comes Ricochet.
Okay.
Juice, what a drop kick! Oh, what's he doing? He's breaking the laws of physics.
Springboard bulldog there, and Ricochet and Matt Jackson are starting this thing out, and Ricochet is starting it out hot, rolling Death Valley driver, and he's keeping. Matt Jackson confined to his corner, goes for release paddle combo into the Pele kick. They're already doing a lot of shit very fast.
It's lucky Eddie isn't in this fight, because Eddie wouldn't know what to do.
No, he would also think that it was stupid.
Well, it's a bit silly. It is a bit silly, Juice.
First tag of the match made to Braun Strowman.
And here comes Bearded Kane.
And he's not going to tolerate any of the Young Bucks bullshit. As annoying as he can sometimes be, he's just still...
He always is. Let's not split hairs here, Juice. Braun Strowman is just as bad as the Young Bucks.
Well, no, he's not at all. He's annoying in a different way, but his actual wrestling...
Oh, could you just control your own narrative for a second and shut up?
Okay, Braun Strowman going for a cover, hooking the leg... Matt Jackson doesn't even give it one, despite being about half the size of Braun Strowman, before kicking out. Ricochet gets tagged back in. Up to the top he goes. Matt Jackson has not moved. Now he's starting to get up, just as I said.
Because he's just blowing those punches.
Beautiful.
By Braun, take it out of you.
Beautiful.
And Ricochet is just following it up, mate. He is. The crossbody. This is just It's exciting stuff. This is what wrestling should be at all times.
Matt Jackson.
Just this juicy.
Matt
Jackson. It should be high flying, no selling, just offense after offense. That's what the fans want to see. That's what I want to see, Juice.
Yeah, so during that little diatribe there, about 20 different things happened. Suplex by Matt Jackson. And standing moonsault, no water in the pool. And Ricochet continues to keep control of this match, Hugsley.
Just combobulate with a shot to the ear like that. It disorientates you. What are you doing, Ricochet? Oh, I'm not. Sorry to judge you. I wasn't familiar with your game. Oh! And back and forth, injuries. It's incredible. It's incredible.
Braun Strowman just. Wait a sec. It's broken down here, bro.
And this is why the Young Bucks are the greatest tag team of all time. That was a poor remark because it's not looking like that at the moment. But they'll come back. I believe in them.
Yeah, Ricochet is like doing some Superman shit right now. Or in his case, Jimmy Olsen shit.
He's like a tiny Cesaro.
No, he's nothing like Cesaro. The fact that they're both bald, he is nothing like Cesaro in, like, style.
But you said Superman, and Cesaro is like Superman.
Oh, fucking shut up. Okay, so... I'm sorry. So,
kind of intelligence you expect from the greatest tag team of all time. They really know how to work as a tag team.
What? Going to a corner and making a tag? Yeah, real advanced.
Exactly. That's the only thing, that's the experience you see from the greats, okay?
Okay, so Nick Jackson now keeping his corner cut off. There you go. There's that tag team work. Ricochet can try and do some of that fancy evasive shit, but it's not. Wait a sec. As I say.
Oh, suplex. Oh, man. I'm worked up. I'm worked up, Juice.
Yeah.
It's the mounting. It just makes me so mounting excited.
Works his way out of that mount. Nick Jackson now doesn't feel like doing any work in this match. Tags his brother Matt back in. And Matt is going for a super kick. Boom. Super kick.
Oh, we've just seen that. End, Eddie. This might be it. The disrespectful pin.
Braun Strowman.
Oh, but Braun taking out the ref.
Braun does not give a fuck about the Young Bucks.
Dodges a fucking super kick.
And he
the awareness.
And Braun continues to not give a fuck.
Oh, and just inserts that penis up his butthole.
Continues to no sell. Mary finally decides to register something. Oh! Wow. Incredible springboard. Wow! Incredible springboard DDT.
Oh, and you can see that was very impactful on the back of the head, the top of the head area. That jars your neck. That could be dangerous. It could be a broken neck right there for Nick. Nick? Yeah, I believe that was Nick.
Yeah, and Braun Strowman somehow is back up after taking a spike DDT on the apron moments ago. But it doesn't matter because about 10 other spots have been done. Ah, a jumping flatliner on the outside by Matt Jackson. Braun Strowman is now knocked out. Nope, he's already gotten back up. Okay, continuing on. Drop kick to Ricochet. And Ricochet is on the wrong side of the tracks, folks. He's dead smack bang in the Bucks corner. And he going for another super kick.
Look, that's great teamwork. That's the kind of experience that I've been talking about, Juice. That's one of the greatest tag team of all time. He misses a super kick before the reversal. You get a punch right there from Nick.
Yeah, and he just the living shit out of him, dude.
Oh, that's to bust a dude open.
Super kick, and he's still in the corner.
Braun needs to do something right here because Ricochet is out. He is out cold.
Wait a sec. Matt Jackson needs to call.
He's going for the hot tag, but Ricochet, he's blocking him.
That's right.
He's blocking him, Juice.
Wait a second. Matt's going to get there, though. Wait a second. He can't figure out how to get around. Oh, super kick to the knee.
Oh, Jesus. That was clever. That was some clever stuff.
You saw there Nick Jackson ran interference. Stuck a fist in Ricochet's ribs in the middle of that rolling German suplex. And allowed Matt Jackson to regain control here. Oh, beautiful spinning kick, but Ricochet is nice and close to his tag team partner.
This also doesn't stop, Juicy. This is another war we're seeing right here. I don't know how it's going to finish, especially with each one coming in to protect their partner, stopping the pin.
Referee nearly getting in the way again like a dickhead, like the guy in the other match did. Nice exchange here. Oh, just a standard elbow to the top of the dome. That's classic wrestling. Very out of keeping with the Young Bucks, but there you go. Credit where it's due. Strowman runs interference again.
Just paying homage to the style that is completely inferior to what they do.
Roundhouse kick, 2, 3. Oh, man.
There it is.
Oh, my God, Monet, I'm seriously going to, come to your house.
I don't know what you're complaining about. This is what you should expect when you watch a team as talented as the Young Bucks.
No, what I expected was for the logical conclusion of this match, which would be this was nice though. I gotta give credit to that beautiful reversal from that springboard into a sit out tiger bomb there. And there you see, this is pretty much where it came to an end off of this elbow to the skull, sending shockwaves of pain down Ricochet's entire body from his head to his toe. Pick him up right there, nailed that spinning round.
Yeah, just clever stuff. And really, that Tiger Bomb was just shades of Vincent Graves versus Steel Kensley.
Yeah, sure it was. I'm sure they've seen it. And now... the Young Bucks just, gleeful, jovial in their celebration.
Oh, athletic, ripped, shredded, sexy, amazing.
Proud Christian Brothers. And coming up next, it is... another World Heavyweight Championship tournament match. It's AJ Styles versus Bryan Danielson. All the independent wrestling fans are about ready to cream their jocks. And here he comes. It's Flat Earth AJ.
I don't know how they've got any cream left after what we've seen.
Oh, man, I've got just enough cream left to get through the rest of the broadcast. Oh, my God. Praise God. Praise God. Fill me full of your cream, Lord. Fill me full of your cream. I want to be filled with you, Lord. Fill me up. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. I want to be full of your cream.
Oh, and you know what, Juice? You've got to believe that he has the power of Jesus on his side here tonight.
Absolutely. The power of the Almighty, the power of the Japanese yen.
Which, the atheist in Bryan Danielson, he can't compete with that.
Nah, man.
Okay?
Nah, man. No,
faithless hedonist, that is Bryan Danielson.
All of his facts and his evolution and his phylogenic record, that pales in comparison to the love of Jesus.
Listen, when the Lord speaks to you, you just know.
Yeah, exactly. You just feel it. It's just something you feel. It's not something that requires anything. Okay, anyway. here comes the American Dragon, Bryan Danielson, and he's looking really good. He's looking all sorts of good. Coming down here for... I mean, these guys have wrestled a number of times at this point, but every time they are going to get in the ring, it's always going to be a match that's going to sell tickets because...
Because it's always thrilling.
Yeah.
Name me a bad match that these two have had, Juice.
They have never had a bad match.
Exactly. You can't say one. Exactly. No. Okay, so tonight will be no different. These men are going to put on a show... for the crowd here at Raw.
Yeah, well, that's what we hope because we need those ratings to come in or they're going to cut off our thumbs. Okay, here we go, and we're underway in this dream match. Oh, and AJ starting it off quickly with that arm drag, that running arm
drag. They have so much experience with each other, Juice. Yeah. You got to think they know each other like AJ, the back of their
AJ,
hand.
AJ, bro. AJ going straight for these snake eyes. boom. Immediately lay down a big piece of offense.
Oh, AJ's just non-stop right now.
That's right, because he wants to stun.
He wants to end it early, Juice. He doesn't want another five-star classic. He just wants to get it over and done with and go back home to praise the Lord.
That's right. Go back to his wife, Wendy, and his kids and Bible study.
I've got church on Sunday. I need to go to bed.
Yeah, he does need to go to bed early. But, it, like, you know, but now we see, though, because the thing is, though, he really doesn't want as a beautiful drop kick in the corner there. I was just going to say, AJ really doesn't want... Oh, he's gorgeous, gorgeous. The Acai moonsault into the reverse DDT. And he's... Oh, beautiful counter. Before I've even got a chance to call...
Oh, knocking this fucking spit out of his mouth.
Into the corner. Another turnfuckle drop kick. That time it didn't quite connect.
Oh, right to the dick hole.
AJ was going for that AJ DDT. Picks him up.
Oh, the wherewithal right there. Reversal into the reversal. Brian Danielson, he's evolving right before our eyes.
That was a terrible, terrible landing for Brian Danielson. He's got a history of injuries. He's going to be fighting through a lot of pain right now. He just landed full force on the outside. And the adrenaline is propelling this comeback that he's making. But it also, you know, it cries out of you know, the desperation of a wounded animal in a lot of ways.
Mm.
A desperate flurry of offense to try to quickly recover from a very critical mistake.
A wounded animal we all know he didn't evolve from, because the Lord's word is all. It is just the one word, DJ. One word, Juice.
And the earth is flat and the center of all existence. Okay. So, and just AJ, though, tremendous wrestler. He's got some pretty out there beliefs, but tremendous wrestler. And we're seeing an example of that. He floats over beautifully
into a modified crossface.
Quite similar to Brian Danielson's own LaBelle lock. He's able to unmount himself. Dismount himself, I should say. Top wrist lock and some body shots are going to quickly dispatch of that problem.
Just knocking the Jesus right out of him.
And again into that float over neck breaker. He's really trying to put the damage onto the neck. One. AJ. Kicking out at one there. But he's continuing on. Danielson
neck
continuing
crank.
On with that. Yeah, beautifully done neck crank. We throw him back down. And then, boom, sending again. Shockwaves of pain down the spine.
Just showing what the vegan diet can do for you.
Yeah. I mean, look at that physique. Looks like he hasn't been in the sun for 15 years. Does Danielson, but look at the physique. And he's gone back into that crossface. He may be too close to the ropes here, Hogsley.
I don't think he's trying to reach for it. He's trying to pry those hands off him. He doesn't want to be mounted like this.
And he manages to dismount himself. Kick to the midsection. Off the ropes. Drop down. Oh, and the clash of heads. That's not going to be good. Oh, a beautiful transition into a cross arm breaker. If he pulls his arm all the way down, gets full extension. He did not. Springboard into a drop kick.
I thought he was going for a phenomenal elbow there. Converts it into a drop kick.
I thought he might have been setting up for one there. Running forearm. Follows up in the second. Pele kick.
He has got to be discombobulated after that, Juice.
That was fucking excellent. Into the cover. Hooks the leg. Nice tight pin. And Danielson just gets the shoulder up at two. And 2 3/4.
Man, that referee is thick. Who is she?
Yeah, man. She's got a fan ass. Referee.
Yeah, it's like a dump truck right there.
Yeah, man. And these two, again, the technical wrestling prowess on display.
Beautiful
reversal sends Danielson face first into the bottom turnbuckle. Oh, and Danielson just takes him out with a lariat. And he's going to continue to work, put pressure on that shoulder joint, that arm joint of AJ Styles.
possibly trying to discourage him from using the phenomenal forearm.
Wait a sec,
he might if he cannot get it off. Oh no, but here it is, here it is, here it is! Juice! Juice, he wasn't discouraged at all!
Two, three. And the thick as fuck referee calls for the win. AJ Styles just barely pulled that one out, Hogsley. You saw there the drop kick in the corner was answered there. The reversal, the springboard moonsault into the DDT. The action was fast and furious. The beautiful armbar transition there. Danielson was not able to get a full extension. Amazing. At this point, boom, springboard drop kick. That kind of was the final turn as far as AJ Styles taking control of the latter portion of this match. Went for that running knee. The reversal was hit. Danielson was still groggy from the impacts to the head. Phenomenal forearm. Perfect positioning. Thick as fuck ref. Looking good in the hands. Three count. AJ Styles is your winner with the help of his Lord and Savior. Jesus Christ.
And that just goes to show, when you go to church every goddamn Sunday, that's what you can do. You can also win the World Heavyweight Championship tournament at Raw.
Yeah, he just beat the demons. Beat the demons.
Beat the demons out of him.
Beat the devil out of Daniel Bryan.
Oh, come on. We've got a main event coming up next, and that's Seth Rollins versus the Celtic Warrior himself.
Yeah, it's
Sheamus.
Yeah, it's our main event banger. You're exactly right, Hogsley. Seth freaking Rollins. Ha ha.
Burn it down.
Ugh. Taking on Sheamus, and here he comes. Ugh. Ugh.
What are you talking about? This guy is the architect. He is the prodigal son, the future cerebral assassin. This guy is handpicked by Triple H to be the next star of the WWE.
Well, he kind of already is, like, the next. The...
No, but he is. He is currently. Okay? This man will take the company to new heights, Juice.
I mean, he's been on the main roster for 11 years. So.
Yeah, and we're still reaching these new heights. It's just a roller coaster ride, and we're on that upward path.
Yeah, and speaking of people that have been on the roster for a long time, here comes Sheamus, who has been on the main roster since 2009. The WWE, accompanied by Butch and fucking, I've forgotten the other guy, Ridge Holland, I think his name is, of the Brawling Brutes.
And you've got to think that this guy, despite how good he is just a more muscular Finley.
Well, you don't got to think that. I don't think
you,
that.
You do.
That's
a slightly larger Hornswoggle.
No, he... even if he did resemble Hornswoggle in any way, he'd be way more than slightly larger. It would be an enormous statement, but like,
twice the size of Hornswoggle.
Okay. In either case, Seth Rollins starting this thing off, you know, aggressively, which he's going to want to do to try to neutralize that aggression of the Celtic Warrior. Oh, but that miscalculation on his part there ended up with a Polish hammer to his fucking orbital bone. And now he's getting the shit kicked out of him by Sheamus.
And this is the kind of just strength and spirit you show when you're just full of Guinness.
Yeah, full of piss and Guinness. Not necessarily in that order. Oh, beautiful snap suplex, but his feet are both right under the ropes, Seth, you fuckhead.
Seth clearly showing that he's not quite cerebral enough at the moment.
Not quite cerebral enough to assassinate Sheamus. Oh, beautiful ripcord knee. Hopefully we don't see 200 of them like in AEW.
That's got to hurt your knees.
Yeah, went to follow it up. No water in the pool. And Irish curse backbreaker.
And a third one.
And Sheamus has capitalized on every single minuscule mistake that Seth Rollins has made in this match. Counters that Samoan drop attempt into a reverse DDT. And now he's just going to fucking rip it in his fucking face.
And clearly Sheamus wants to win this. to get a new camper van from your ma.
Yeah, he wants a new camper. Oh! Holy fucking shit, dude.
Look at the fucking hops on Seth Rollins. He just cleared those ropes they were nothing.
Oh, dude. Hopefully we get a replay of that from Darren in the truck, but I won't hold my breath. And now they're fighting on the outside here. He needs a new caravan for his mare, but he just got flipped on, and now he's getting his fucking guts pounded out here. And not in that way, or maybe in that way, but right now.
Oh, mounts him. Oh, Jesus. No, you don't do that to your fellow man.
Oh, my God.
No, when he's fighting for his ma.
The ref got all the way up to 9, I believe. Oh, Seth Rollins just absolutely fucking destroying Sheamus. A buckle bomb right onto that fucking...
These bombs are landing.
I mean, a buckle bomb onto that barricade. The back of his head crashed into it. He hasn't been the same since. Seth Rollins is trying to lock this thing down and bring it home. Sheamus, though. Celtic Warrior.
That back has to be snapped in half.
And when you use a lot of aerial offense, a lot of kicks like Seth Rollins does, a lot of jumping. Oh, you know, an injury.
You need that core.
You do. And he somehow manages to pull off a springboard knee. Picks him up. This is his last ditch attempt here, I think. Reversal.
What?
Oh, no.
Sheamus might have here. Another one. Oh, but Seth with the wherewithal.
Beautifully smooth reversal by the architect. Sheamus trying to keep control.
Off the ropes. To the gullet. To the bread basket juice.
Picks him up. Oh, and just flings him.
That's dangerous. The back of his head.
The shot to the back of the head. The same area that was impacted with that powerbomb into the barricade. And he kicks out at 2.5.
That could end your life. That is where the brain stem is. So many careers have been ended after a rabbit punch like that, Juice.
Absolutely. Rollins up into the corner with a forearm.
To the back of the head again.
Curb stomp.
Oh, there's no way he was getting up. There was no way. His ma will have to wait for a camper van another night.
And here we see the replays. Those consecutive Irish curse backbreakers. As in the latter half of this match here, we thought Seth Rollins might have been a goner after all that impact to the back. But he managed to keep up a fierce competitive edge throughout this thing.
He was deadly tonight, Juice.
You see here, boom, tremendous athleticism.
Show it. Where's that? Here we are, Juice. This was so fucking dangerous and devastating.
Boom.
Oh!
His head just slammed.
Oh, yeah. So nice. We had to see it twice.
Absolutely. You just see his face, his neck, his skull. High impact with the barricade. And then a springboard, a double jump springboard curb stomp. The ref can count to 150. No one, no matter who you are, not even Sheamus, is getting up from that. Seth Rollins advanced in the World Heavyweight Championship Tournament. Dolph Ziggler advanced in the Heavyweight Championship Tournament. And fucking Daniel Bryan advanced in the Heavyweight Championship fucking tournament, I think.
We'll see you down the road.
The following announcement has been paid for by the WZWA Network.